A nuclear reactor run by undergraduate students at a liberal arts college sounds like an interesting idea, but it's real and it's been here at Reed College in Portland, Oregon for 50 years. And yeah, we're gonna put a camera in it. Go for it.
The Reed Research Reactor is a TRIGA reactor. It's designed to be operated by students and designed to be used as a training reactor. We got it because we had a radiochemist on Reed's faculty. He thought that it'd be really important for students to have access to this cutting edge technology that was nuclear reactors. So we have a tank that's 25 feet deep. It's full of around 25,000 gallons of water. We think that we have enough uranium to continue operating at our current rate for 100 years without having to change it out. We operate at 250 kilowatts, which is actually a pretty low power. While it does produce power when it operates, there's no way of harnessing that to make electricity. The main purpose of our reactor is for science.
The kind of research we do is called neutron activation analysis, and the logic behind it is if you don't know exactly what something is made out of, you can make it radioactive and then find exactly what it's made out of and then like work backwards and figure out what it was originally. And then let it sit in a room until it decays, and then you have your original thing back. You can put 80 things in there, you drop it into a tube, and then you turn it, and it turns, and it gets the same amount of neutron exposure, and then we get it out with a fishing rod. And then afterwards, you have to be very careful with it, because it's contaminated. But the water at the bottom of the reactor becomes radioactive. It has N16 in it, nitrogen-16, but because N16 has like a half-life of 7 seconds, when the water is cycling through, it gets diffused through a nozzle, which causes the new water to like swirl around like this, which makes the delivery time from the water at the bottom of the reactor to the water at the top of the reactor just like a few seconds longer than it needs to be. So water at the top isn't radioactive, and that's one of the coolest parts about our water system.
The radiation levels that the reactor produces is actually very low, but the water provides sufficient shielding, so it's safe for us to be in here while the reactor is operating. It's a very small reactor. It doesn't get hot enough to melt down. It doesn't explode. So the way we shut down a reactor in an emergency is with something called a scram. So we have a special button. It's labeled the scram button. And when you press it, it cuts power to those electromagnets, and it automatically shuts the reactor down. If someone drops their phone or some other object into the pool, normally what we do is we get a bucket on some string and we try to scrape the object into the bucket with a very long stick, or we wrap duct tape around heavy weights and we lower the weight into the pool on a string and try to pick it up that way. We have a pretty good success rate.
Can we turn the lights off so we can see the blue glow? Wow, that looks awesome. The blue glow is Cherenkov radiation, which is a bit like the visual equivalent of a sonic boom, but there are other people much better qualified to explain that than I am. Research reactors aren't very common, but there are more than you might think. There are a couple of dozen in the United States alone at universities and research institutes and a few companies. This one is basically a student society, just a student society with a lot of regulation and oversight.
So before you're allowed to operate the reactor, you have to get a license from the US Nuclear Regulatory Commission. Our students train for an academic year before they sit down for that exam. You have to do things such as memorize diagrams for our cooling system or our ventilation system. You need to be able to explain how the physics work, how to protect yourself from radiation, and how to actually use the controls of the reactor. We license 15 students to operate every year. Currently, we have 30 to 40 students on staff.
You don't get academic credit for working in the reactor. And I think part of that is because we get paid to work here because this is a job. This is the reason why I came to Reed. I just thought it was really cool that this was a facility that existed at a school. And I was like, I'm gonna do that. When I first started the training program, I had to pull aside the training supervisors and say, like, you have to explain the atom to me from the beginning because I don't know anything. I worked really hard and I just really wanted to know it. Now I know it, and I still think it's really cool, and I get to do cool things like operate this.
Thank you so much to everyone at the Reed Research Reactor, and in particular Val and Carrie, who are putting my camera into it. Pull down the description for more links about Reed College and about the reactor. I'm looking at a nuclear reactor. Oh, wow. I have never actually seen Cherenkov radiation in person before. It's amazing.